Demo of a digital control system for the WMU course ECE 5700. Okay, what we have is a basic control system which has an error measurement here. There's a plant which we show as GP of S and its output is Y, which is fed back here. It's compared to a reference input R. The error is fed through a gain amplifier K, which produces an output which is then sent to the plant, and we call that C. The key equation here is C equal K times R minus Y. We'll be coming back to this one. Okay. Stop. Okay, well, for us now in our system, a GP of S is really a first order RC system, which is the same transfer function as a DC motor. Okay, our R is 1 mega ohm, and our C is 0.1 microfarad. This gives a transfer function, and here's C, and here's Y. The transfer function will be this, which comes to 1 over 1 plus SCR. R times C, the time constant, is 0.1 second. So this is the open loop time constant of the plant, is 0.1 second. And what happens in the closed loop system? We find the closed loop transfer function, it will be look like this. And from here we can say two things about the closed loop system. One is that the time constant of the closed loop system will be much lower than the time constant 0.1 second of the open loop system. Okay. As K increases, the closed loop system will respond faster and faster. But what about the DC gain of the closed loop system? It's K over 1 plus K. So at K equal to, as K increases, the DC gain will be larger. So it will be half at K equal 1. And let's say at K equal 4, it will be 4/5. So as K increases, the DC gain will increase. And so will the time constant go down. So speed and gain, DC gain both increase as K increases. And we can show this graphically now. Let's see what R we are using. Before we do that, we should know that our Y range is 0 to 5 volt. So in our system, Y is limited 0 to 5 volt. So I've chosen R to be within this range to be 1 and 3 volt. R is taken as a square wave that goes between 1 and 3 volt. How will Y respond? We can see that as K changes, the response of Y will be different. For a low value of K, let's say for K equal to 1, Y will oscillate between 0.5 volt and 1.5. And we start off at 0.5, go up to 1.5, and it'll go pretty slow. And then drop back. So, what about for if we increase K to 4? In this case, because of the larger DC gain, Y will go between 0.8 to 2.4, and it'll respond faster. So, based on these situations, we can see that the shape and size of Y will depend on K. Let's talk about our system hardware. This represents the microcontroller. Okay. And there's a plant. We have a RC circuit for the plant. Y is fed into the analog input of the microcontroller. The software of the microcontroller will generate the R in software and calculate the C. The C is outputted as an 8-bit digital code. Well, at this point, it's just 8 bits. If you see here, at the point where R changes from, say, 1 to 3, the error will be as large as 2. So depending on the value of K, if we want larger K, say, K equal 4 or 5, C can be as large as 10 volts. So we need to have an output here, C, up to at least 10, maybe 15 volts. So we have a D2A converter here. The output of the D2A converter is restricted to 0 to 2 volt. So I have an op-amp circuit here, which takes this range 0 to 2 volt and outputs a range here of plus 15 to minus 15. And so our C value can range from plus 15 to minus 15. And Y is restricted to 0 to 5. So in our next segment, we'll see oscilloscope pictures. And we want to remember that Y is limited to 0 to 5 volt. And C can vary from minus 15 to 15 volt. The largest value of C will occur when this transition happens. And as the Y catches up with R, then C will decrease. So we'll see a lab demo of all of this in the digital control 2 video.